Sunday tomorrow, I have to make pasta tissue.
All right, guys, we're about to get started. You ready? I'd like to call the February 21st, 2023 board meeting to order. Can I have a roll call, please?
President Goodwine.
Present.
Mr. Smith.
Present.
Mr. Sampson.
Present.
Mrs. Wick-Gagnet.
Present.
Dr. Pickett.
Present.
Mrs. Rhynard.
Present.
Mr. Lacey.
Here.
Seven present.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Thank you. I believe, Dr. Lally, we have a special recognition today.
Yes, we have all of the fall sports city champions, and I see a very nice crowd out there that we are getting ready to honor. Whenever you hear your name called with your team, please come forward to the podium, receive your award, and then shake hands with all of the board members, the treasurer, and myself, please. We look forward to congratulating you.
Board members, join us down to shake hands.
Good evening to the Dayton Board of Education and family and friends and parents. We appreciate you all for having us down here today and recognizing the 2022 city champions, Dunbar football. Yeah. All right, guys, real quick, before we start, I'm gonna call your name. Come on around. 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 I'm gonna call your name and give you a certificate. First up, Elijah Appleberry. Cameron Avery. James Bailey. Shaheen Bowman. DeAndre Bean. Tristan Bozeman. Christian Calmeese. Tony O'Casey. AKA Orangutan. Next up, Man Boy, Ja'Kari Casey. Ja'Kavian Casey. Yeah. Uriah Cranford. Jaywan Craver. Nissan Boy. Adonis Davis. Keyshawn Golden. Javian Graves. Rayvon Hooks. Isaiah Jolly. Ishmael Jones. Brian Payne, Jr. Kieron Price. Demetrius Turner, he's not, his mom is here though. Demetrius Turner, we're gonna give Demetrius here. Myquan Ward. Deriontay White. Devontae Young. Darian Price. Yasmin Larkins. Bryce Nelson. Jordan. And last but not least, Derek Hardy. I apologize, I'm gonna bring my sisters up too. A couple of my sisters here, Ira George, Coach. And Alfred Powell.
Yeah, go on, say it, go on. We will now have Stivers Middle School, 7th and 8th grade volleyball team.
Okay, first we have Shania McDaniel. Miracle Taylor. Rain Wheat. Mia Myers. Zoe Wright. And Micaiah Gillis. That was both 7th and 8th grade, and I was the coach for both.
Next, we have EJ Brown football team. It's combined 7th and 8th grade, and they're here with Coach Henry Warren.
How y'all doing today? Coach Warren, Edwin Joe Brown football team. Up first, we have Nicholas Agee. Gerard Austin. Christopher Lutek. Myquan Harrison. Robert Scroggins. Darion Drake. Jairus Taylor. Nate McCorkle. Tristan Woods. Jamari France. Jermaine Richardson. Perrion Patterson. Jerome Ellison. Tavion Johnson. Corey Evans. Lindsey Wiggins. Demirion Foster. Layton Smith. Maurice Watts. Tyler Henderson. Our amazing team manager, Maya France. And my assistant coach, Fernandez Jordan.
Next up, we have Belmont Girls Cross Country and head coach Kim Norsworthy.
Thank you, board member, to the athletic staff and to the Belmont staff, Ms. Principal Cicchetti. This year, we are, I would like to say, this is our 10th year winning the City League Championship. So that is a big time accomplishment. So thank you guys once again for just acknowledging our girls and their accomplishments. First, I would like to call Claudine Awima. Safa Daoud. Anaya Siambra Morton. Anaya Moneyham. Miriam Delman. Kaden Thorpe. Emerus Malik. Nuella Mukadinkinzi. Gentile Mukadinkinzi. And Angelina Santiago.
Next, we have Ponents Boys Soccer and head coach Jelani Boone.
Hey, thank you all for having me today. First thing I want to say is I appreciate the opportunity you all gave me. And for a first time being a coach this year, it was absolutely life-changing, something that I want to continue to do. And I want to thank you all for giving me the opportunity. So the first name I have is Abdella Abdella. Second name is Ikyamba Amuri. Hold on. Let me make sure I got the wrong ones. Next we have Masakala Amuri. Next is Misimbwa Hassani. We have Adidas Kashindi. Yafet Mahari. Benjamin Matunga. Clement Shizarunga. Emmanuel Rashidi. Jules Rashidi. Norbith Saadi. And that was our last one. I thought we had more. I'm sorry.
Next up, we have Stivers girls volleyball team and their coach, Anthony Jackson.
Good evening, board members. How are y'all doing today? I would like to introduce the Stivers varsity volleyball. Six consecutive seasons with a win, city championships. So first up, we have Phoenix Carter. Maggie Holmes. Catherine Jackson. Taryn Nooks. Zora Nooks. Sadie Smith. Kira Steele. And last but not least, Paige Young.
Next up, we have Stivers Cross Country Boys and their coach, Aaron Werdelicki.
Good evening. Thank you so much for the opportunity to recognize our athletes. This is my second year coaching cross country here, and it is the first year we had a full boys team, and all of them were first year participants, so I was really proud of their performance. I only have two here this evening. Several of our kids are on the basketball team and they're playing right now, so good luck to them. So I have Judah Lindsay. And Sabri Kazenga.
And last up, we have Stivers Girls Soccer with their coach, Muhammad Ahmad.
Good evening, board members, and thank you very much for organizing this event. Stivers Girls, I had about 21 players, but Stivers Girls usually involved in so many other things. I only have five who showed up, but I'm going to read the whole team because it's being recorded. Is it being recorded?
Yes.
Okay. So I have Jasmine Avila, Sophie Benke, Brooklyn Massa, Grace Bruner, Lauren Buck, Isabel Bellerman, Lily Fink, Amaya Gibson, Jasmine Grant, Kamaria Hughes, Ophelia Jacobs, Ayana Jones, Jayla Lee, Luisa Ilunga, Gabby Mallory, Atalia Mason, Anaya Rogers, Chloe Ryan, Danielle Scott, Shelby Knowles, and Rain Shiloh. The five are Anaya Rogers, Amaya Gibson. Ophelia Jacobs. Brooklyn Mesa. And Lauren Buck.
Can you? Yes, please. Yes. Sorry, one more time. I hate to make you stand up, but I used to do this too. So. Good evening, Board President Goodwine, Vice President Smith, Superintendent Lally, Treasurer Abraha, and Board Members Cabinet and attending and watching public. It won't go. I am Nancy Nerney, former DPS board member, present chair of the board of the Dayton Public Schools Foundation. As you know, our organization's goal is to advance the success of all DPS students, supporting the efforts of you and the district superintendent to accomplish that. We only deal with Dayton Public Schools, so if without you, we would not exist. This year, we again made available our classroom grants of up to $500 to all DPS teachers and our school grants of $1,500 to all DPS schools. Because of the generosity of your employee donors and our community donors, we are able to announce our teacher grants for 2023 with more than $6,000. It is our eighth annual round of offering grants. This year, from 16 applicants, we bring you 14 grants, and they're all not here, so you don't have to worry about standing too long. But anyway, we'll bring these grants come from innovative teachers finding creative ways to reach their students with materials not able to be provided by the district. Our grants have been diverse, from cooking activities to field trips, to flexible seating options, enabling students to find the best spot to stay calm, focused, and productive. But this year, we are excited also about a $10,000 contribution from Alta Fiber, other name is Cincinnati Bell, that will go toward purchasing new musical instruments for DPS bands. Since we serve only DPS, we appreciate whatever help the district can give us. That particular grant was aided by an alert DPS employee who supplied information encouraging the company to give. We are grateful to the district's HR, PIO, teaching and learning departments, and the treasurer's office for their support implementing these grants. We're pleased to now have permission to have a donor button for us on the DPS website alongside yours. We truly believe that these grants from our donors enable us to directly impact the success of DPS students. As our students grow, so does our community and the value of its future citizens as they give back to the community. I'd like to now present our DPS Foundation community members, and there's one here. Is there anybody else from the board? From the community, from the board. It's Shelly Outlaw. I think the rest of them probably got lost trying to find where this was. And Shelly's going to help us with the certificates tonight to give those out to the people. I also wanted to mention that we will be coming to you from March 6th to 17th because that is our employee campaign. So just dig down deep in your pockets and donate for future grants that we're going to be giving out. So thank you for your guidance for our school district. We look forward to continuing to serve you and your students. So we'll go through the names, and I think there's just probably one person here. And I hope that you will get a copy of these teacher grants so you can see the diversity of the kinds of things we are financing. I gave it to Charisse. So Amber Banks did one on learning environment improvements. Charles Cox, we helped him with his chess club at Meadowdale. Kelly Cox with flexible seating. Alicia Foster from Charity Adams with learning games. Joel Lynch has been doing Friday cooking. So if you get hungry, try Friday afternoon at Wright Brothers Middle School. And Patricia Lewis did calming cubby. And she's got calm down corners and safe spaces in her classroom. Congratulations. Thank you very much. Kevin O'Donnell at Meadowdale CTC is working on a rhythm section. Carson Euler is doing flexible seating at Cleveland Elementary. Janetta Parker is doing a field trip to the Masonic Tent Center to learn about Aesop's fables. Katie Philpott was doing informational texts for her Rosa Parks pre-K students. Dale Pike of Ponant CTC is teaching Tai Chi. Andrea Ravelli is doing student seating. Oh, you're here. Oh, good. Did he get his? Watch out now. Evie Racino was doing decodable books for her kindergarten children at Fairview Elementary. And, oh, she is here. Good. And Hannah Stewart is doing a complete set of flexible seating for her students at Wright Brothers Middle School. So we congratulate these teachers for their creativity. Thank you very much.
All right, everybody settle back in. Next on our agenda, hearing of our bargaining unions. Do we have any bargaining unions that would like to speak? You got to pull it off. There.
Good evening. Protocol being established. President, Superintendent, and the Board. Hi, I'm Marie Winfrey, Local 627 Transportation, school bus driver. And I'm coming on behalf of the drivers. We have concerns. We're going to have our facility redesigned, and the Transportation Department is going to be doing a lot of construction work over the summer. But as I was speaking with the Executive Director, and business manager, Mr. Lawrence, Dr. Lawrence, they're stating that the drivers will be still there in the building while they're doing the construction, and it is going to be done in phases. My question is, where are we supposed to go during the time of the phases? Have they considered that we can be placed in another location during the time this transformation is going on in the construction, we need to consider people due that have allergies and have breathing areas. They're going to be tearing down walls, painting, and issues of that. So I was asking the board if they can consider us to go to another location during the time of the restructuring. And I understand it will be starting at the end of the school year in May or June, but we will be coming back in the building in August, and we do know that everything will not be completed at that time. I would like the board to consider another location or another area that we can be placed while we are under construction at the transportation department. So thank you.
Thank you. Madam Treasurer, do we have any individuals in the public registered to speak?
Yes.
Okay.
Monique Smith.
Okay. Let me just read a couple things real quick. Please limit your remarks to 3 minutes. It is inappropriate to address any matters, including pending disputes, grievances under a labor agreement, disciplinary actions, including an employee or students, ongoing labor negotiations, concerns or matters that have already been settled, and or any matters which, because of the nature, is deemed inappropriate or deemed appropriate to be discussed in executive session.
Yes. Okay. Good evening, everyone. I'm just a concerned parent, and my daughter came to me about some concerns on the book that was given to them to read to do a report on. And that book had some things in it that I really couldn't explain to my daughter, you know. It had some very embarrassing words in there. And I'm just trying to figure out, what do I do? You know, I didn't know what to tell her. I don't even know how it's allowed. So I'm here to, you know, find out how this can be handled and maybe where it doesn't happen again. I don't know if y'all want me to read a little bit of what's in the book. I mean, it could make some people uncomfortable.
Can you tell us the title of the book?
Yes, ma'am. It is Ellen Foster, written by Kay Gibbons.
Dr. Burton, could you get details about where this is located, et cetera, with this talk with this mother, please? And thank you so much for sharing that with us. We'll take a look at it with our curriculum team and follow up on that. And if you don't want your daughter to read it, please write a note into the classroom teacher right now and ask for an alternative selection.
Okay, so that's allowed.
Yeah, well, I'm telling you it's allowed. So let her know that whoever the teacher is, let them know that Dr. Lally is recommending that you write in because you find the book offensive. And then we'll research this and take a look at it for future as well.
Okay.
So thank you for bringing that to our attention.
Thank you, ma'am. I would like to thank you for your time, and I want to thank having the support of Black Lives Matter of Dayton. Thank you. And thank you for hearing me.
Thank you for coming out. Madam Treasurer, do we have other speakers?
Yes. Carlos Biford.
Good evening, everyone. my name is Carlos Buford. Longtime Daytonian. I had 4 kids come through the Dayton Public Schools. They're doing fairly well right now, thank God. And they're all grown. So, and I just want to reiterate what my sister Monique Smith had mentioned about the book by Ellen Foster. I have questions and concerns as well. And those questions are, for example, what is the objective of reading that book? That allegedly portrays blacks in a substandard representation. What is the approval process of books like this? And are there books approved by the schools on lynchings or inventions by blacks that could possibly place the N-word in its corrective context? Because sometimes when we hear the or read the N-word, which was in that book, and I read it myself, it's in a book. And unfortunately, the context with it, you know what I'm I'm saying? And we need to make sure that we get our students to understand the negative connotation behind that and the history behind that word. And also, with that said, I can't help but believe that there are no books that exist that allows the K word to be read in relation to the Jewish community. And to me, if we're going to be talking about the N word, there should be some talk about the K word, because this is history. This is American history as well. And there are some other things, even with the LGBT community. Put everything into context, okay? So that's just some of the things that I'm just believing that it doesn't exist, but it exists for the N word. And last but not least, I have many questions and concerns, and I am asking that our Dayton School Board address my concerns and my sister's concerns immediately so that we can also move forward, because we do have an incident out there in Springfield. We did address that as well. And unfortunately, our kids are going through a lot of hell, and we have to make sure that we put our kids first and let grown folks deal with the hard stuff. Thank you.
Thank you. Madam Treasurer, do we have any other speakers?
No, that's it.
Pursuant to section 121.22G2 of the Ohio Revised Code, I move that this board go into executive session. This meeting is being held to consider the discipline dismissal of a public employee. Do I have a second?
Second.
It's been moved and second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Mrs. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
7 yeses. All
right. Join me to the left in the conference room. Yes. All right, everybody is back. Let the record show that the Board of Education of the Dayton City School District has just completed an executive session during which it considered the dismissal and discipline of a public employee. I move that we exit the executive session. Do I have a second?
Second.
It's been moved to second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Mrs. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
7 yeses.
Thank you. Madam Superintendent, your first recommendation.
I'd like to move to item B, consultant services, and have the board take a look at that. I recommend approval of the consultants that are listed.
I move that we approve item B. Is there a second?
Second.
Second. It's been moved and second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
7 yeses.
Your next recommendation?
I'd like to recommend the approval of the contracts listed under item C.
I move that we accept the superintendent's recommendation. Is there a second?
Second.
It's been moved to second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
Seven yeses.
Your next recommendation.
Under item D, I do not see a recommendation there, so I think that might be a placeholder for something else.
Okay.
Item E, I recommend the approval of the agreement that's in executive content.
I move that we accept the superintendent's recommendation. May I have a second?
Second.
It's been moved in second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
Seven yeses.
Your next recommendation?
I'd like to recommend the approval of the Montgomery County Youth Career Services agreement statement.
So moved.
Second. Being moved in second, are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
Seven yeses.
Your next recommendation?
I'd like to recommend the approval of the Sinclair CCP agreement.
So moved.
Second.
It's been moved in second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Mrs. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
Seven yeses.
Your next recommendation?
I'd like to recommend the approval of the Memorandum of Understanding between Public Health, Visible and Resilient, and the Dayton Public Schools.
I move that we approve this recommendation. Do I have a second?
Second.
It has been moved in second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
Seven yeses.
Are we ready for your other recommendation, or would you like me to come back to you?
Ms. Kidd, do we need to refresh?
No, you need to
come back.
Okay. Thank Madam you. Treasurer, may I have your first recommendation?
I recommend the approval of the supplemental appropriation for fiscal year 2023 as reviewed last week.
So moved. Do I have a second?
Second.
It's been moved in second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
Seven yeses.
Your next recommendation?
I recommend approval of the amended certificate of estimated resources as reviewed last week.
So moved. Do I have a second?
Second.
It has been moved in second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
And Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
Seven yeses.
Your next recommendation?
I recommend approval of the permanent transfer for Fund 013.
So moved. Do I have a second?
Second.
Did you get the second, Madam Treasurer? Because there were two voices.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
It has been moved and properly second. Are there any questions? Mr. Sampson?
Thank you, Madam President. Quick question. This permanent transfer for $6 million is for the project of Welcome Stadium?
Yes.
All right. Madam President, do we have like a something to explain to the community? I know when we first started the project, the board was going to be responsible for $12 million out of the settlement that we got, and then we just approved $9 million last month. So we're up to $21 million. And so if this is approved tonight, it will go up to $27 million. And the project, I believe, was about $44 million. Like, how much more of resources is the district going to have to pay for this project?
Is your question for me, or would you like me to give you the staff for it?
Give it to.
Would you or Dr. Lawrence? Go ahead.
Right now, what the $6 million transfer will do is finish up the press box. So in reality, the entire Welcome Stadium project with the new field, the press box, the bleachers and the stands and the track and underneath on both sides in the concourse, those will be completed by using this money. The additional money that would need to be raised would pay for the extra field for the discus and a field house and then the extra storage. I don't want to call it a barn, but the extra storage building that had been earmarked for the UD arena end inside the stadium area. So that's all money that has to be raised to pay for that through fundraising efforts.
So, Dr. Lally, is there a way to present this plan to the community in essence? Because we stated one thing at the beginning of this project, and now we're still increasing. I understand the work needs to be done, but to some in the community, we're now, if this is approved, we're up to $27 million when we thought it was going to be just the 12, because I know we got to do fundraisers and things of that nature. Like, is there a way to present this plan to the community?
Yes, and actually the initial one where we actually had Skanska and Shook come in was, I think it started off, and correct me if I'm wrong, members of that team, I think it was around $27 million that we started off with. And then with the cost of materials, construction, and the addition of course, the field house, the field and the building, the extra building, that increased some costs there. But yes, we can do that for you.
Thank you. Thank you, Madam President.
Are there any other questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine.
Yes.
Mr. Smith.
Yes.
Mr. Sampson.
Yes.
Mrs. Wick-Gagnet.
Yes.
Dr. Pickett.
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard.
Yes.
Mr. Lacey.
Yes.
7 yeses.
Madam Treasurer, your next recommendation?
I recommend the approval of monthly financial for January 2023 as reviewed by the Finance Committee on Thursday.
So moved. Is there a second?
Second.
There were two voices, Madam Treasurer. Did you grab one of those two?
I grabbed Mr. Lacey.
That works. It's been moved and properly second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine.
Yes.
Mr. Smith.
Yes.
Mr. Sampson.
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet.
Yes.
Dr. Pickett.
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard.
Yes.
Mr. Lacey.
Yes.
7 yeses.
Your next recommendation?
I recommend the approval of the minutes for January 10 and 17.
So moved. Is there a second?
Second.
It has been moved and properly second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine.
Yes.
Mr. Smith.
Yes.
Mr. Sampson.
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet.
Yes.
Dr. Pickett.
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard.
Yes.
Mr. Lacey.
Yes.
7 yeses.
Your next recommendation?
I recommend approval of the donations for February 21, 2023, as reviewed last week.
So moved. Is there a second?
Second.
It has been moved and properly second. Are there any questions or comments? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine.
Yes.
Mr. Smith.
Yes.
Mr. Sampson.
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet.
Yes.
Dr. Pickett.
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard.
Yes.
Mr. Lacey.
Yes.
7 yeses.
Your next recommendation?
I recommend approval of the following purchase requisitions as reviewed last week.
So moved. Is there a second?
Second.
It's been moved and properly second. Are there any
questions? Who seconded it? You? Okay.
It's been moved and properly second. Are there any questions or comments on the motion? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Mrs. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
7 yeses.
Your next recommendation?
I recommend approval of the following then and now as I reviewed last week.
So moved.
Madam President, can I vote separately on the Montgomery County Treasurer real estate taxes assessments for 2023?
I move that we pull the item that Board Member Lacey has stated to vote separately on. Is there a second?
Second.
Is it moved and properly second? Are there any questions on the motion? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
So we're voting on everything but now?
We're having a vote to pull that item separately.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay. President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
All right. I move that we accept the treasurer's recommendation, absent the one item that we just pulled. Is there a second?
Second.
It's been moved and properly second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
7 yeses.
I move that we accept the treasurer's recommendation on the single item that I believe is the Montgomery County Treasurer's real estate tax and assessment. Is there a second?
Second.
It's been moved and second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Okay. Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Abstain.
6 yeses, 1 abstain.
Does that conclude your recommendations?
Yes.
Are we ready to come back to yours? Board members, please refresh your screens. Madam Superintendent, your recommendation.
I'd like to recommend the approval of the HR agenda as listed.
So moved.
Second. It's been moved and second. Are there any questions or comments? And has everybody had an opportunity to look at it? I'm going to give you a second to make sure y'all refreshed your screens. All right, any questions or comments? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
7 yeses.
Does that conclude your recommendations?
It concludes my recommendations for this evening. Thank you.
Thank you. Dr. Lawrence, your recommendation.
I recommend the Board of Education approve the resolution to terminate Skanska.
All right, so moved. Is there a second?
I have a question.
Oh, we got a motion. And then we'll put you on. Okay. So moved. Is there a second?
Second.
Is it moved and properly second? Any questions?
I do.
There you go. There you go, board member.
Yeah, I understand why we're doing this, but I think I would like for Dr. Lawrence to explain to the public why we're doing this.
Skanska is a construction management firm. They began the Welcome Stadium project by making sure that the contractors, Shook Construction, and others, that they did good, solid work, and that we didn't have to go back behind them with our operations team, as we've had to do in the past with buildings and other projects, to go back and fix them again. So we're terminating that contract. I'm recommending that we terminate that contract We have internal individuals who are capable of shepherding this project the rest of the way. Skanska's got us off to a good start, but I think with the board active participation in this process and our internal people that are involved, I think we can move forward without them.
Are there any other questions? Go ahead.
Thank you, Madam President. Thank you, Dr. Lawrence. I appreciate the explanation. Just as somebody who has gone through this process before and wishes that we had done it differently and wishes that we had had a company like Skanska when we were dealing with Ludlow 2, seeing a lot of the things that went into the project that were unanticipated, that caused the project to cost a lot more, and seeing as how, you know, we are already looking at expanding the budget for Welcome Stadium, I just have so many concerns about being responsible for this project and cost ballooning or unexpected things happening. I fully respect the staff members that we have on board. I understand, you know, they are very capable individuals. This is not anything personal against the work that they do. Just trying to be as responsible as possible, which is the reason that we entered into this contract and, you know, finishing and finalizing Ludlow 2, recognizing the mistakes that were made and trying to make sure that they didn't happen again. I feel very conflicted about this. Do we have guardrails set up for ourselves to raise any alarms for if the Welcome Stadium project were to be at any point raise some of the red flags that we saw with Ludlow 2?
Board Member Ryan, your concerns are fair. And I think they should be addressed. And so we do have guardrails. We have a transition plan that we have with Skanska to go through the process of transitioning from their folks to ours. And then our systems are in place. We'll be there for a minimum of 2 hours per day. We'll journal what's going on there, provide daily updates to me, and then weekly updates to the board. If we find that we see things that have gone awry, then we'll move from there to process other ways to get back and possibly have a corporation like Skanska come in, if we have to.
Can I ask you a follow-up question?
Sure.
If we were to realize that we were in a situation and we were in over our heads, that we needed to re-enter a contract with Skanska, would there be additional cost to have to re-enter it? Would it be something where long-term we would end up paying more anyway because we had exited the contract and then needed to re-enter it again? What does that look like, the process of re-evaluating and having to go back and change our minds?
It might not even be Skanska, that's the next company. We would open that as a bid process. And I'm not sure that, let's just say it might not be Skanska that does that, that goes through that process the next time, but it will be someone. And I don't know if it will be more expensive or not.
Thank you.
All right.
Are there any other questions or comments? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
Okay. President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
No.
Ms. Rhynard?
No.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
5 yeses, 2 no.
Does that conclude your recommendations? Thank you. I recommend the approval of the following board members' travel and expenses and reimbursement. Is there a second?
Second.
It's been moved and properly second. Are there any questions on the motion? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
7 yeses.
Thank you. Before we get into comments, I'm actually going to do a little policy work real quick. Okay. In so much as the Board of Education is committed to the continuing updating of its policies, rules, and regulations, manuals, and the committee, which was appointed, has been working towards the goal. The following is brought at this time for a second reading in compliance with the board files. Now, therefore, be it resolved, the Board of Education of the Dayton City School District, Montgomery County, Ohio, hereby accepts and adopts the following policies that have been codified for inclusion in the Handbook of Policies, Rules, and Regulations. It's going to be file GBCD, JFE, KGB, and KKA. I move that we adopt the following four policies. Is there a second?
Second.
It's been moved and second. Are there any comments or questions on the motion?
I do have some questions about that.
Go ahead.
Madam President, looking through the first policy for issuing proclamations.
That's not the one we're on yet. This is just the second reading one.
Oh, I apologize.
So do you have any questions on the second reading of what we're voting on?
Yep, on the second reading. Apologies.
Okay, so no questions. Okay, any other questions or comments? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine?
Yes.
Mr. Smith?
Yes.
Mr. Sampson?
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet?
Yes.
Dr. Pickett?
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard?
Yes.
Mr. Lacey?
Yes.
7 yeses.
Thank you. Next, this is a resolution to adopt the board policy. This is the first reading. In so much as the Board of Education is committed to the continued updating of its policies, rules and regulations, manuals, and the committee, which was appointed, has been working towards that goal. The following are brought at this time for first reading in compliance with board policy, or board file BFC policy adoption. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Board of Education of the Dayton City School District, Montgomery County, Ohio, hereby accepts and adopts the following procedures that have been codified for inclusion in the Handbook of the Policies, Rules, and Regulations. Files, they have not been determined yet. These policies are being read for the first time. As such, a motion or second is not required. The policy will be available in the superintendent's office for review and comments prior to their second reading and adoption by the Board of Education. Furthermore, the policies will be reviewed by the superintendent's office, the board's office, and the legal department of the Dayton Public Schools prior to the second reading. Even though this is not up for a vote right now, Board Member Reiner, you had some questions and comments, so I'll go ahead and allow those at this time.
Yes, I do have some questions about, I was getting a little bit ahead of things. I have some questions about the proclamation request information policy up for first reading. There have been some conversation about this before. I have some concerns about it, and I'm looking at some of the language behind the policy. Looking at number 3, individuals or organizations requesting a proclamation from the Board of Education must provide the board with draft language. However, the Board of Education reserves the right to modify the language appropriately. The board further reserves the right to deny any request for proclamation that does not align with the circumstances under which a board proclamation may be issued as stated herein. I think I just would like some more written out direction as to what that screening process per se would look like. Is there a time period that the board would have to research and look into the draft that's submitted to the board? What does the process look like for the board to either accept or reject it? Would that be a vote at a meeting? Because it clearly says the board and not a subcommittee. What are the standards that we are looking at to understand that a draft proclamation aligns? What exactly are we aligning with? The interpretation in the language that it does not align with the circumstances under which a board proclamation may be issued. I see that there are things a little bit early. I'm just concerned about the lack of structure here, and I just wanted to raise that concern. I don't know if there's any conversation that any board members would like to have over this. I understand the desire to recognize individuals and organizations. I think that there needs to be some really thoughtful, intentional guidelines. I already see a couple concerns that I have about what is here and wanting to get some further clarification.
Thank you. Dr. Lally, can you please inform Board Member Reiner of what the process was that the policy committee came up with, how you guys would actually process these requests?
The process that was recommended was that the proclamations would come to the superintendent and two additional people and be reviewed for appropriateness. HR is involved in that process and would do research and background information, make sure that the data, the information were correct, and that this would truly be someone that the board would want to issue a proclamation for. And then at that point, the proclamation information would be reviewed, make sure that it's appropriate, and then followed through to the board, sent to the board at that point in time. Did I miss anything?
The second part of who that second person was, because it's not the two the two stationary individuals are the superintendent and HR.
And then it would be someone, for example, if it's curriculum, if it was a curriculum related issue, it would be someone from the curriculum, the chief of curriculum. If it's someone from a building, we would have a principal who helped us review that. If it was someone from generally from a building that the school chiefs could review, correct? Did I miss anybody on that? So it would be related to whatever. The third person is a rotating person based upon who the proclamation would be about and for. So if it's something with athletics, then it would be Executive Director Jones, for example.
Okay, thank you. Are there any other comments? All right, if none, we will go ahead and have closing comments. I will go with you, Board Member Sampson.
Thank you, Madam President. I just want to say that since our new assignments of having different schools assigned to us, it has been a joy this month to visit the schools that have been assigned to me. But first, let me say that I had an opportunity to attend senior night at Belmont, and it was absolutely an awesome time. I do want to shout out Belmont Pep Band, absolutely incredible. And I want to say thank you to Mr. Williams Rolak for his incredible work watching those young people play marching band style. A lot of people that was in marching band, it brought back a lot of memories. So shout out to Belmont and the Pep Band. I also want to shout out the educators that I had an opportunity to watch stand in proxy as surrogate parents for those athletes who was being recognized, whose parents couldn't be there for whatever reason. Just watching that community support and pour love into all of those athletes, it was absolutely an amazing time. And so on February 10th, I had the opportunity to visit Horace Mann, Ms. Moss, the principal, her office staff, nutritional services. Everybody was amazing. But I got to give a special shout out to Ms. Katina, who is the custodian there. Her energy is just undeniable. She loves what she does. Amazing, 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 amazing. And then I went to Westwood. As always, Westwood front office staff is very welcoming. Got a chance to see the males of colors and community and schools, liaisons working hand in hand. One of the highlights for me always at Westwood is that sensory room. I love that sensory room. And then also, during the last month since we met last time, well, we met last week, so before that, I got a chance to hang out at Jackson for the operational lunch and got to see some amazing people there. I do want to say a shout out to Coach Chastain for being named Coach of the Year, and then also to Mr. Davis, assistant principal at Meadowdale, for being recognized Parity Inc.'s top 10 African-American men. He was recognized last week. And then lastly, I want to say to our Dunbar High School and Edison family and the loss of a student, I want you to know that you continuously are in our thoughts and in our prayers. And one more. February the 15th, I want to shout out all of our SROs. That was National SRO Day. And so thank you to all our SROs for the amazing work that they do day in and day out. Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you. You were very active. I like to see that in you. Board Member Rhynard.
Thank you, Madam President. I have a number of updates to bring to the board that I think are of relevance. The first is I'm wearing a couple name tags today. Don't usually wear more than one name tag, but they both have different meanings, so I'm wearing them both today. The top name tag is last month I attended the NSBA Equity Symposium and the Advocacy Institute. I've done this for a number of years. It's work that is deeply important and that that brings a lot of value to what I do here on the dais. When I was appointed as the delegate for the Federal Relations Network, I was proud to be able to officially represent DPS and work with the OSBA in advocating for public education in Washington, D.C., and I've done that for a number of years. I had a fantastic meeting with Senator Brown's education staffer. She's doing really good work. She's actually from Dayton. She had a lot of questions that I was able to answer for her on the spot, and then she sent me with some questions that I asked Dr. Lally about for further clarifications. I was really excited to share some of the things that we're doing with our teacher pipeline programs and partnerships with other universities. Some of the things that we advocated for on a federal level for public education that I shared with her is ensuring that each classroom has a highly qualified teacher, increasing access to broadband connectivity, providing support for historically disadvantaged students, providing support for students with disabilities and mental health needs, which is of particular interest to our district at this time, and then pandemic-related learning loss. I believe that Senator Vance's office is still working on getting his DC staff up and going, so I wasn't able to have a meeting with him, but I will make contact as soon as they're up and rolling. The second name tag that I have is some of the work that I do with the Ohio School Board Association. Once again, I'm a member of the Board Member Cabinet Committee for the second year. Really proud to do that and to support the board member the board of the OSBA. I'm also a Southwest Regional Executive Committee member. Our motto is Southwest is best, and I firmly believe that. And I am a continued delegate for the newly named Federal Legislative Advocacy Group for the new consortium that Ohio is a part of. Called COSPA, and we are going to be going to, I'll be doing some more advocacy in DC at the 2023 conference later this year. There are a number of state house legislation updates that I would like to bring to your attention that are relevant to the work that we do here. It has been a very busy couple weeks in the state house. There's been a lot of new legislation that's been introduced with this new General Assembly, most of which are of deep concern to me as an advocate of public education. Not everybody in the State House is aligned with our vision for the importance of public education and funding it properly. The first is Senate Bill 1. This was a bill that was proposed last year, and then with the ending of the General Assembly, they had to propose it again. This will rename the Department of Education and transfer the powers and duties of the State Board of Education to the renamed Department of Education and Workforce. It will move a lot of the responsibilities of the State Board underneath a cabinet position in the governor's office. I have concerns about the justification and the timing for this bill. There are a lot of questions about the timing, particularly in regards to some of the newly elected State Board of Education members. House Bill 1 will modify the law regarding property taxation and income tax rates. This is incredibly, incredibly damaging to public education. It will strip billions of dollars away from public education and millions of dollars away from Dayton Public Schools. This is something that is, this is part of an effort to dismantle public education. And I oppose House Bill 1. And I'm happy to bring more information to my board as they desire. House Bill 6 is something, as a parent of a trans kid, I have a lot of reservations about. This is a law that will require schools to designate single-sex teams and sports for each sex. It is a law specifically designed to harm trans students. And it will only affect 6 students across the state. There's no real need for this law at all. And if we're talking about mental health needs, if we're talking about populations that are higher risk of suicide and mental health issues, this is the population that directly is affected by a bill like this. A bill that I am not feeling negative about is House Bill 10. This bill will continue phasing in the school funding system from House Bill 110 of the 134th General Assembly, and hopefully continually to phase it in. If any of you recall the information I brought to you about House Bill 110, it was the Fair School Funding Plan, and it laid out a 6-year phase-in for a constitutionally adherent method of school funding. The roadblock is that it needs to have legislation to fully phase that in throughout the years. And House Bill 10 is something that will continue the phasing in. So I am in favor of House Bill 10. House Bill 11, which is relevant to, I know a couple members of this board have heard about this bill, which was under a different number in a previous General Assembly, is the Backpack Bill, which will create backpacks of money that will follow students and basically take public tax dollars and put it towards private entities, non-public and charter schools. Again, something that will deeply affect public education, particularly urban public education. And House Bill 38 will allow kids to take up to 3 mental health days per year. This is sponsored by our local state House representative, Representative Blackshear, as well as Representative Jessica Miranda. I'm really grateful for this legislation. I think it will do good things for providing kids the ability to take off 3 mental health days per year. The last thing I want to say, 2 things. My heart goes out to our families who have experienced loss this school year. Both recently and, you know, a few months ago, we see their pain and we wish that it was an experience that they were not having to go through. I would love to see what conversations we can have as a board to provide more supports. I think the MOU that we signed, that we agreed today, for the resiliency is a step in the right direction. Any loss is one loss too many. And I share your grief as much as I can. And then the last thing, this was not mentioned last week, and I failed to bring it to attention, and I believe that it's something that we need to recognize, is that on the HR agenda was the resignation of our superintendent, her official resignation. We are deeply grateful for everything that you have done. Dr. Lally, I am sad to see you go. I wish that I hadn't seen it last week, but I wanna acknowledge that it was there and thank you again. You're still here, you're not going anywhere. We still have you. But I'm, again, grateful for the way that you care about Dayton, the way you care about public education and the work that you've done over the last 5-6 years that we've been working together.
Thank you.
And that is all I have, Madam President.
Thank you. Board Member Wick-Gagnet.
Okay. No, just kidding. Thank you. Part of my committee work, of course, is our Business Advisory Committee. Happy to report we'll be kicking off our first meeting of the year on March 1st, where we will introduce our work. I believe Board Member Sampson was questioning, you know, the campaign and our efforts to raise the remaining money to build this field house that is continually evolving and being reimagined in a way so that we make sure that as many of our students and families come to this space as possible. So I think it's really exciting. So in this work, we're inviting our business community leaders to participate in looking at what this what the current work looks like and then the vision moving forward so that then hopefully we can create some allies and raise some funds along those things. It's exciting that we have a local Dayton Public School graduate class of, I'm not sure. The Roth High School, Keith Byers will be our business co-chair this year for our business advisory work, which really pairs up nicely with alignment with the work at Welcome Stadium. Keith is a football legend, if none of you know, Philadelphia Eagles and Roth High, Ohio State High, or Ohio's the Ohio State. So anyway, but we're really thrilled to have him work alongside us. I think it will really bring value and opportunity to our kids and community. So I'm excited about that work. That meeting is March 1st, and I look forward to doing some pre-meeting to line everything up. So looking forward to that. I have been to all of my schools. I have both Dunbar and Edison schools. So my deepest condolences continue to go out to the families, and especially to our educators in those buildings who hold such space for these students who are experiencing this trauma, which is far too frequent. You know, we think it doesn't happen, but it was 2 weeks in a row, folks. I would like to compliment our internal team, Superintendent Lolly, and everybody who responded by sending out all of the resources that these buildings needed to give resources to the leaders in the buildings so that they could help with the children. And it was really, if you can gather any beauty from any of these things, that is one of those things. And they truly felt supported, and it was nice to do that work. So I'm happy to be there. I can't continue to reinforce the importance as we move forward with our education model. I fully believe that mental health and many of these issues that our kids face should really be a part of our curriculum. Mental health and the things that our kids are dealing with social media. I mean, it is an ever-changing world, and I think it's really important as a board and as educators that we continue to do the deep work that's needed there for all students, but in reality, we serve a very vulnerable part of our community, and we need to be extra vigilant to make sure that these kids are getting resources that they need. Along those lines, I've also been to E.J. Brown. It's probably my favorite school. Junior high is such a special age, and really doing a lot of work there, and Rosa Parks and Kaiser. So one of the things I really love about this work is when I ran originally to be on the school board, could always ask myself a question, or people would ask me, why are you running for school board? And I've always contended that, you know, relationship, it's all about relationships. And I think I'm a relationship expert, though I'm probably not. A few people would probably challenge that. But I do believe that we all have this innate need to connect. And when I have the opportunity to be in these school buildings and connect with these students and these people, you know, I continue to learn about myself. They continue to learn. I'm starting to be recognized. I had a few football players tonight from Dunbar, which was really humbling to me that people are starting to know me and value the work that I may be doing by just going there at lunchtime and talking to them, which is super fun. So I would encourage us all to continue to connect, Buzz. I think that I think we all learn to love ourselves better through connection. So it's this reciprocity thing, and we can help these kids learn to love themselves better to connect. So keep doing that. My third piece, I kind of jumped around there. We did a lot of good work with our Black History Month, so kudos to Superintendent and our Stivers kids who put this beautiful artwork in the front windows. I think it's really lovely. Our PIO team who continues to push out great information every day. Thank you for that work. And a special shout out to my dear friend, Ms. Pat Day, who did a lot of work with the Geraldine Blunden stamp effort. I think our kids learned a lot. She did some work with our curriculum pieces, and our kids were really engaged. Geraldine Blunden has started the Dayton Contemporary Dance Company, which is a local, nationally renowned dance company, also a Dayton Public School graduate. So it's really wonderful to celebrate our local legends during Black History, so which will go right into Women's History, or Women's Month in March. So I'm looking forward to seeing what we can collaborate to do there. So another piece of attending the Montgomery County Educational Business Dinner tomorrow night. excited about that. And my other committee, I'm beginning to do some other work on, and I'll have more to report on. So thank you to Superintendent. Thank you to the rest of our team and everybody for the work that we continue to do. I think we're doing great work, but I know there's a lot of work to be done. So I look forward to continuing. Thanks so much.
Thank you. Board Member Dr. Pickett.
Thank you, Madam President. The ESL committee is going to start meeting next month, and we're going to be meeting at the international school. I also want to echo Board Member Rhynard's sentiments in regards to the loss of our students. I know that as a school district, we're doing everything that we can. I don't know if there's anything more that we can do, Dr. Lally. But it's really painful to see teachers and students and parents and family and friends wondering, I could have had one more conversation, I could have done something. And that is a feeling that no one needs to live with. So my heart goes out to the families, and hopefully that we can do something about this. Also, through the library, I had the ability to speak with a lot of our high school students. And the stories that I hear about the busing are really, really disturbing. And I want to invite everyone to think about, if you're in a yellow bus and somebody comes in and tries to sell you drugs or expose themselves, that's something that we cannot imagine. Yet our students have to deal with things like that on a daily basis on the public transportation. And I know there are no people, there are no culprits in this room in regards to that. That's a big, big fight that we need to take to Columbus, definitely. But that's something that I'm hoping that we can do something quickly to help our students. They should not have to go to school and feel afraid on the way to school or home. So that's all I have to say, Madam President.
Thank you. Board Member Lacey.
I want to express my appreciation to the teachers everywhere, especially the teachers that have to deal with a national Adderall shortage. They're the ones, more than anybody, that have to really work hard to, because of the screw-up in our national supply. I'd also like to report that the Finance Committee met last Thursday and looked over the finances, and they're in great order. And then I'd like to wish everyone a happy Mardi Gras for the next few hours. Thank you.
It's Fat Tuesday.
It's Fat Tuesday.
Yeah.
Vice President Smith.
Thank you, ma'am. I just want to start out. We have some athletic updates. I just want to thank our athletic staff. Most of them are here today. Executive Director Jones and her team have been doing an excellent job. Went to an event, Who's in the Jersey, over at Belmont. That was one of the greatest events I think I've seen in the past few years in this district. And it was really powerful. I think the biggest testimony I can come up with was, on the way home, my daughter said, you know, I want to go back and play basketball again. And just to see her, who come out and say, you know, seeing this panel of young women and young African-American women talk about the things that they went through, from, you know, the lows to the highs, to being professional athletes, college athletes, but then just using athletics as just a piece to grow their self-esteem, to stay active, to get friends. It was packed. There was no room to sit. I appreciate Dr. Lally and Dr. Lawrence and everybody that was involved. Saw Miss Maney out there with her jersey on. So, I mean, it was just amazing to get all of those students over there. I think that was just a blessing. So I really want to give kudos to everybody that was involved with that. Moving into the spring, I do want to let people know that we have added boys volleyball. So if you have any young men that would like to get out there and do volleyball, we also have tennis, baseball, softball, and track and field as well. So we have those things coming in the spring. And currently, we have some teams finishing up with wrestling. Kudos to them. Went to the wrestling tournament this past weekend. Me and Dr. Goodwine were treated to some great wrestling matches. I think something that I looked and realized, I wasn't built to be a wrestler, so I want to give props to all the wrestlers that were out there. I want to say thank you again to our staff and just growing the number of young ladies that were out there wrestling. And I want to give props. One of the young ladies won her weight class, and it was a combined weight class. And for a championship match, she pinned a young man. And just to see her face when she did that and see the gym explode, I mean, it was great. That event was great. They've just been doing a really, really good job of getting more people involved in these events, letting these students know that whatever they do, we're going to lift it up. I appreciate those things that have been going on. If you look online, we still have some coaching needs. So if you can check that out, that would be great. Also, it is Black History Month, like was said. I appreciate all the things that have been going on at the schools. I love going over to the schools during Black History Month and seeing just what they're learning. One of the things that I've seen there's been a shift from in the past few years is there's been a shift from just talking about these global Black history icons into talking more nuanced stories, an understanding that we're living Black history. Black history is made every single day. And so seeing that these kids are learning that and understanding that. And with that, I do want to shout out the people that, you know, were in this district that got me here. People like Vera Hill, people like Joni West, rest in peace to Byron Day, and rest in peace to John Cooley and Mr. Ed Ward and Gary Martin and Charlotte Burks and William Waters and Marlena Randolph and Donna King and James Lacking. People that are in our district and have come to our district, they're Black history. They are people who have raised excellence in our district. And so I want to shout them out and the things that they do. I want to shout out everybody in our district that does so much for our children every day. And so I really appreciate that. I love Black History Month. I love what our children are learning. I love that the pride that they get from learning about themselves. I really do. I really appreciate that. I love seeing this year that the Black National Anthem being sung in our schools before basketball games. I've loved that. I've loved seeing other schools stand up and hold hands and seeing parents and grandparents start singing in the stands as the song's going on, seeing students learning the words as the season goes on, seeing students go from instead of just playing a rendition to singing it. I saw a kid play it on the guitar at one school, like just seeing these things and seeing the pride that evokes. So I appreciate that. And lastly, I want to echo the sentiments of other people on the board. My heart goes out to these families. It has been a trying time in this district, not just at some of these schools, but understanding our community is so small, even though it seems so big and divided and all over. If something happens at one building, it affects kids all over this district. They go home, they live in the neighborhoods with these kids, their families know each other, and it goes from public schools to charters to parochials. These kids all live in the same neighborhoods. I do want to give a major, 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 major thank you to Dr. Lally, to Chief Hayden, to everyone that went out into these buildings and were there to serve. Really came in and said, what needs to be done? I really appreciate that, Doc. And hearing from staff members that, you know, staff that, you know, they hear about these things and come to school and realize, you know what, I haven't eaten since 3 o'clock the day before. And so those people that just came in and said, hey, here's some food. Here's some pizza. Here's some cookies. Understanding that it pains us. It pains the bus drivers to see these pick up these kids, the custodians that have known these kids, the teachers that see these kids. So I just want to say that we as a community just love on each other, give grace to each other, talk to each other. And with our young students, please understand that whatever is serious is in their world is serious in their world. A lot of times we look at things as they're being trivial. We look at social media and these kind of things, but it's serious. And so I just want to say, please love on each other. I really do appreciate the response that has been shown in this district and has really shown me how much this district is a family. Especially being someone who spends a lot of time. I live around the corner from Edison, and I'm at Dunbar all the time. And just seeing the pain on these babies' faces. I appreciate Athletic Director Jones and their team again on what they've done for Dunbar's basketball team and that family and everybody there. So just want to say we have to love on each other because life is not promised. You never know. No day is promised. So fill every day up with love and love each other, and we have to move this district forward. So thank you, Madam President, and that is all.
Thank you. Dr. Lawrence, do you have any closing comments?
Yeah, I'd like to thank transportation, 80 buses, getting 15 of the 16 elementary schools to the University of Dayton for a girls' basketball team game. Also, who's in the jersey? There were about 45 buses out there. And every weekend, when some of us are off, Saturdays and Sundays, there are field trips. Transportation is 24/7. And it's the one, it's the space where people talk about that the most, about what's not happening. But I want to talk about what is happening. And they continue to push during the day to get uncovered routes down from 18, 19, 20 down to 4 today. So there's going to come a day soon when we're going to have all routes covered and get all kids to school. And we're going to do it consistently so that we can gain back the trust of the community. Thank you to Tierra Anderson and Brian Erskard and the Ruskin Rams. They invited me out to teach a third grade class for Black History Month, actually the whole third grade. And Emma, your gift card's on the way. She guessed my age on the first try. I thought I looked younger than that. And also to the students that we've lost, this is a call to action. So moving forward, all of us need to put our brains together. And typically when things like this happen, there's this idea around thoughts and prayers. But then we have to do something after that. And so let's give that some thought as a community. Thanks.
Thank you. Madam Treasurer.
We just had a post audit today for our financials. And the auditors found no errors in our financials. And that means we got, thank you. That means we got a clean audit report. I would like to congratulate my team, the treasurer's team, for their superb work. And I'd like to thank the board and the superintendent for the help, for their help. That's it.
Thank you, Madam Superintendent.
Thank you. I'd like to echo some of the comments that have been made tonight. It's a very heavy heart having to go through what we've gone through in the last couple of weeks. And I know that our teachers, our staff, and our families are also feeling that. The SRO team that Chief Wright put together to support the two buildings, the work that Dr. Burton and her team did to support the buildings, both were exceptional, and appreciate the ongoing work. We are working on some prevention programming that we'll be bringing to the board in the next few weeks, but we are vetting some things right now, taking a look at some additional supports besides the resiliency coordinators and the SBTs that are already in our buildings. We're looking at some additional programming options that we can bring forward and talk with the board about those things to support our students. I also want to mention that the Ellen Foster book that was mentioned tonight is not on the part of the approved English language arts curriculum, so we will take action on that and make sure that everyone understands what's acceptable and what's not in our curriculum. Tomorrow night, we have our voices competition at Wright Brothers, and that's always a great opportunity to see students do their speeches and compete against each other. It's always so much fun to especially watch the younger students and how well they do in standing up there in front of a large audience. So that'll be a really nice event. The BAC dinner tomorrow night with Montgomery County, the Business Advisory Committee, Board Member Rhynard, Board Member Lacey, Board Member Wick-Gagnet, our CTE directors, and I will be attending that. It's a required meeting that we have to go to because we're part of that larger organization as well as having our own BAC here. So we'll be representing Dayton at that. Dayton has been chosen by Strive Together, which is a national organization, to be part of an interview process about COVID recovery. So I'll be part of that interview that they're doing next week through Learn to Earn Dayton and the Strive group, which is a national group, and that should be aired at some point. I'll let everyone know when that's going to be there. Read Around America is on March 2nd. If you haven't signed up to read to our students, you're missing out on a fun time to go in and wear a Dr. Seuss hat and read to our students. Read Across America is happening in all of our buildings, so please check in and see if you can read it at one of your assigned buildings to do that. And in addition to that, the Black History work that's been done by both the Stivers artists that are on the Ludlow 2 building, but also in our classrooms and in different performances that are occurring have been very, very good this year. And just want to congratulate staff and congratulate the students for the great work in making sure that we celebrate and understand their heritage and information that we don't always get to talk about in our classrooms, like Mr. Smith indicated. So that actually concludes my report for tonight.
Thank you. That's everybody, right? Yeah. I'm going to start off again commending just really the individuals who all took place in responding to the crisis that we had. I mean, I saw a side of Dr. Burton I've never saw in my life, but she came in there and she commanded a room. She made sure that people that needed help got help. Psychiatrists and counselors were everywhere, and it was amazing just to see how when something impactful in life happens, how people transform and respond in ways that you didn't even know people were capable of. Even with the Edison family, and actually I'll say too, with the Dunbar administration, I mean, that entire team over there, you're never prepared for when these situations happen. So just to see how well our team responded in making sure not only that our students' needs were met, that our staff's needs were met, offering additional services to families, because we don't talk about therapy enough and counseling and talking to someone, and seeing that our team went above and beyond just the school day. I believe they offered a couple sessions outside of the school day to allow families to come to the school and talk, because it's the first step. I mean, we live in a time now where you got to talk to somebody. You have to get it out, and you have to be able to feel comfortable doing that. And even seeing our elementary team at Edison, again, it was a quick reminder that this is a family at so many levels when it comes to how people interact together. So from, I think one of my colleagues have already mentioned, from ensuring that people ate, to ensuring that people were at the school, to hearing the kids talk about the school is a safe place for them. So they wanted to be there because it was a place that they could grieve with people that they felt safe around. So I just commend the entire staff, because again, it's an impossible and it's an unimaginable situation that you never want to go through. But your response was, I mean, there's nothing that I can say that you could have done better in that moment. And I hope that we don't visit this moment again. But I'm proud that the people who were surrounded at every level, even the board members that went out to check on the school, the superintendent that made sure we had, from Chief Wright ensuring that they were protected in that environment. Just kudos to everybody that did anything to be a part of us trying to grieve as a community. And now we're in the phase of us trying to heal and be preventative. And as you heard, we're working relentlessly to find solutions and to find things that meet people where they are and that give people that opportunity to just talk to someone. And again, I'll echo one of my colleagues. If you are around children, talk to them. If you're around teenagers, talk to them. And just because in our day, some of the things that they go through seem minor to us, you got to know that they are living in temporary moments, and they think of a lot of permanent solutions just to get through a temporary moment. And we got to be there for them to help them know, like, we can get through this together. So I'll go on to, I do want to give a shout out to
Executive Victoria Jones and Executive Director Victoria Jones and her team, the Who's in the Journey jersey piece was again a phenomenal event, and you heard individuals buzzing for days about it. And to see that, as we know that females have a stereotype that we can't all be in the same room and collectively do something because we'll get catty. I mean, it's a thing out there. But to see that that room was filled with 90% teenage girls, and they were attentive, they laughed, they danced, they had a great time, and they did it all. And then even seeing too, I mean, I know there was, to watch our kids as they wear those hoodies that we bought them, the pride that you see in them throughout, not just in the district, but throughout the city, is amazing. And it's just, it's those small little gems that just bring a sense of pride and help us build to what we're really trying to get here, like that sense of pride of, I'm a part of something. And to see all of them in that moment go, I'm a part of something, there's something bigger, and just listening to the range of stories, I think it was just the most, it was a well-executed program that just, I hope to see more like it, and I hope to see that our students can actually connect with the range and the variety of speakers, because it wasn't just the one-size-fit-all speakers. It was from every life walk of life, from individuals that came from foster care to individuals that grew up in two-parent households to individuals that had some skill set on the court to people who were actually really good. So just to give them that, it doesn't matter where you are right now. There is education, and being a part of something can take you farther in life than just being by yourself. So kudos to the athletics team, because they have been, they've been killing it day in and day out. And I know we ask a lot of them, and we rarely tell them thank you. So let me publicly tell them thank you for all that you are doing for us there. On top of that, I want to give a, I am not as studious as Board Member Wick-Gagnet, because I made it to all but two of my schools. But I was at a lot of other schools, so that really should count. And one of the schools I got to go to was Kemp. And Kemp has some amazing things going on, just seeing their building and the life that is in it. And I want to give a shout out to Principal Ernest and Assistant Principal Armstrong. They showed me some really great ideas I never thought to be in this school. Like, even in their century rule, they built, like, and it'll be on my Facebook page, they built cardboard houses that are safe places for kids to go when they need a moment to break. That's it's something I never saw in a school, and it's something I never would have thought of, because I mean, it's not my profession, but just to see how these little cardboard houses, they have lights, they have bags, they have things that can help a person who needs a moment to relax through it. So, and I go, I can't wait to continue to see what I see in all the other schools that I get to visit. I do want to give a shout out to our operations team, because they have been constantly on the grind. They gave me access to the request thing, and I fill it up. They knock them out, and just seeing that their responsiveness is just amazing when they are aware of a problem, and they are getting on it. They're following up. Their customer service is, again, that is something that I think, believe we have a committee now for that too, but just seeing that we are treating each other the way we want to be treated. So I want to give a huge shout out to the operations team, because they are constantly just helping us improve and maintenance what's going on in our buildings. Other than that, I want to say for some of my committee work here, the policy committee met for the first time this year, and it's amazing because we're doing a little something different than in the past, where we've brought in some individuals who've never been on policy, and we are starting to have really good conversation about if policies work, if they work how we want them, and if they should move forward. I do want people to know the policy meetings are open to the public, so you are free to come in and talk with us about these policies when they occur. The technology and buildings operation team met today. Again, another group that we are challenging to move farther, to talk about, again, how we can be better as we think about how we are using technology in the different spaces. Right now, we're focusing on transportation first, as well, not just transportation, but how we're using our ID badges and how those interact in the different phases that they can. And transportation was just the main topic, but we're looking at that throughout. I want to echo again, Dr. Lally, our Voices in Dayton Speaks is tomorrow at 4:30 through 7:30. Just stop in sometime if you're in the area. Parent engagement also has a meeting at Thurgood. Again, another opportunity, I believe that's at 5:30. Stop in, see what's happening in that area. Other than that, I do want to give a shout out to my aunt Cheryl Spencer, because I did not mention her when I talked about my mother and my aunt, and I got a lot of flack for that. But she has been a very, and continues to be a very strong person in my life that keeps me on my toes and that gives it. She was a part of building what you guys get every day. I believe every wittiness that comes out of my mouth is because at one point I got in trouble for it while messing with her. And I thank my aunt for that, as we're in Black History Month, that not only do I come from a strong family, I continue to be a part of a strong family, and not only just my biological family, but my life family, that we continue to push each other and challenge each other in ways that I love to see, because we're growing here. Like, even on this board family up here, we are growing. And we don't always get along, but we always get the work done. And with that, I think that's all I have for you. I have a motion to adjourn.
Second.
So it has been moved to second. Are there
who
any questions?
Who seconded it?
Joe Lacey.
It has been moved in second. Are there any questions? Seeing none, may we have a vote?
President Goodwine.
Yes.
Mr. Smith.
Yes.
Mr. Sampson.
Yes.
Ms. Wick-Gagnet.
Yes.
Dr. Pickett.
Yes.
Ms. Rhynard.
Yes.
Mr. Lacey.
Yes.
Seven yeses.
We are adjourned.